بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. Verily all praise is due to Allah whom we seek His help and forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils that we conceal and from the consequences of our evil deeds. Whosoever Allah grants guidance will never be led astray, and whosoever He leads astray will never find guidance. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. And I attest that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, who has no partners. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. And I attest that Muhammad is the final messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. We all know the situation and the processes that are going to happen after death because we are Muslims. As Muslims, we have the details that non-Muslims don't have. Every other religion gives you details about this life and the hereafter, the life after. But only Islam gives you the exact details that you need. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. This is going to happen. If you do this, that's going to happen. So we know the situation and the processes after death. After death, we know that the angels come to us in the grave and they ask us three questions. Before death, we know that the angels come to us. And one of the angels' name is the angel of death, Malak al-Mawt. And if we did good, he takes us to a better place. But if we did bad, he takes us to a worse place. Worser than this place. This is the dunya. The dunya isn't so good. So these processes and knowing all of this information gives us a requirement, leads us or not leads us, but puts us in a situation where we have to take some action, different action. And this type of action is sharing the knowledge that we have. Sharing the knowledge with who? With the Muslims or the non-Muslims? With both. But when we focus only on the Muslims, this will be good. This is Islah. But when we focus on the non-Muslims and with the Muslims, this is Da'wah and Islah. Da'wah means invitation, to invite to the truth. This is what da'wah is. Islah means to rectify, to fix the people, to help them change from bad to good, from evil to righteous. You see, when we uphold the good characters that the Prophet ﷺ upholded, because he was a walking Qur'an, did you know? The Prophet ﷺ, they asked his wife, how was the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? She said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was a walking Quran, meaning that he walked with the words of Allah and he acted upon it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us to be righteous in this Quran and he gave us instructions to follow. By following these instructions, the outcome is good, only if you follow. But if you don't follow these instructions, the outcome is bad. Especially when you die, you will see that. And after death, of course. And we know in the Qabr, the three angels, the two angels come to ask three questions. The two angels come to ask three questions. And they ask us who our Lord is, what our religion is, and what did we used to say about Muhammad? Who is your Lord? My Lord is Allah. How will we be able to answer these questions? My Lord is Allah. Do you think if I say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله and then I leave this Islamic center and get busy with dunya, do you think that when I die, the angels, when they ask me these questions that I will be able to answer because I one day took shahada? No. You may take shahada today and you may be very persistent in seeking knowledge. You may even come here every week, but one day something happens that pushes you away from seeking knowledge. So then what happens? That pushes you even further away from the deen. When you stop seeking knowledge, you move away from the deen. This is a big issue that we are suffering. Many non-Muslims come to Islam, but when they come to Islam, when they say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, do we see them again? Most of them, no. Some of them, few of them, yes. So then what is our mission? What is our role? Our role is to make sure that we have a process of procedures and steps to follow with the non-Muslim, even if we are not da'is or working with an Islamic center. All of us have some non-Muslim friends, and these non-Muslim friends, we are required to invite them to the truth that we know. We have some sort of knowledge. this knowledge, we have to call the people to. When we call them to this knowledge and they accept it, and they accept the truth, we get the reward. But if they accept it and then we leave them alone and not call them again or remind them, then this becomes our responsibility and we don't get the reward, but we get the sin, the evil deed. Why? Because we have a responsibility. We called him to Islam, we invited him, but after that we didn't see him anymore. Why? Because we forgot to get his number, we forgot to get in touch with him. So this remains the issue. So then what is the solution? Since every problem has a solution, the solution is that we make sure that we get the contact details and we make sure that we encourage the brothers to come and get educated, wherever it may be. Let them get educated, let them seek knowledge, and us, we stay motivated and we stay encouraged so that we can motivate others and encourage them as well with us. Now on Yawm al-Qiyamah, we know that we are going to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As a matter of fact, not only are we going to see Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, but we are going to see Adam, Nuh, Musa, Isa, and all the other prophets, including Ibrahim alayhi salam. And every believer, all the believers, according to Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, the believers will run to Adam and they will say, Oh Adam, help us. You are our father. Help us on this day. We need your help. Adam will say, my Lord is angry in a way that he has never been angry before. Go to Nuh. Then everybody will go to Nuh. Oh Nuh, you are a messenger. You are the messenger of Allah. Help us on this day. Because everybody's going to see difficulties on that day. Everybody's going to see the sky scrolling up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to scroll the sky. Everybody who was alive will die. And everybody who died will come to life. And you will see the shaitan. You will see Fir'aun. You will see all these evil people that were mentioned in the Quran. And you will know then, you will know the truth. Even if you didn't understand it in this dunya, in the akhirah, you will understand it. You will see the truth with your own eyes. And when you see Nuh, and when you see Musa, and when you see Isa, they will all tell you Allah is angry in a way that he has never been angry before. Go to another prophet. Go to Isa. Then they go to Isa. All the believers go to Isa. Isa says, Allah is angry in a way that he has never been angry before. Go to Muhammad. I cannot help you. Jesus tells the believers, go to Muhammad. I cannot help you on this day. Go to Muhammad. Perhaps he can help you. So then all the believers run to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they say, O Messenger of Allah, O Muhammad, you are the most beloved to Allah. Help us on this day. Please intercede for us. Look at this difficulty that we're going through. Please help us. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, out of his mercy, is allowed to prostrate. At that moment, he prostrates. He does sujood. And when he prostrates, he says, Alhamdulillah. And he repeats Alhamdulillah in different ways. And he says, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, raise your head. So then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raises his head. And then Allah says, ask and you shall be given. Intercede and the intercession is for you on this day. Subhanallah. So then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what does he say? Ummati, my nation, he wants to save the people, the sinners of this ummah, of those who followed Rasulullah, he wants to save them. They asked him during the dunya, during his life, they asked him, who is the intercession for? I'm sure we all heard of intercession. Intercession is when somebody saves you or protects you. So they asked Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is this intercession for on Yawm al-Qiyamah? He said, it is for the sinners amongst my ummah. It is not for the righteous people who prayed on time and did good deeds and had sincerity. It is for who? For those sinners who were late to prayer, for those people who didn't seek knowledge. It is for them. Rasulullah sallallahu cries, Ummati, Ummati. While he was alive, he used to cry, my nation, O Allah, he couldn't sleep at night. My nation, O Allah, he never even met us. Us now, these days, this people, he never met us, but he knew who we are, and he knew what we're going to go through, and he knew how much sinning we are going to do. And He also knew of the fitan, the tribulations, and how difficult life is going to be for us. So he used to cry, and he used to say, Ummati. And Allah would respond to him, don't worry about your ummah will be safe. But we have to act upon the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we have to save the people of the other nations. Da'wah is important. If you have the basic knowledge, you should go out and introduce Islam to others. But before you do so, make sure that you have the real, authentic, basic knowledge that you sat with your teacher with a pen and paper and took notes and studied Islam, and you know the basics. You know it really well so that you can go out and present it to others. And when you do present it to others, the next step is when somebody accepts Islam through you, make sure that you stay in touch with that person so that you can encourage him and motivate him to remain as a Muslim. Many people say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, but few of them continue with Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Many of them leave Islam and they follow their own desires. And following our own desires is a big, big issue that needs to be solved. And it can't be solved unless if a teacher stands up and presents and represents Islam and teaches it. And before teaching it, he has to apply the teachings to himself so that he doesn't look like a fool when he teaches Islam and not applies it to himself. Because when we teach the truth to the people and the people see that we are not applying it with ourselves, when we are not applying the teachings, then why would they take us as a role model? So we have to be the role models so that at least if we cannot call the people to Islam with our tongues, then we can call them to Islam with our actions, and that is known to be much more effective. So from now on, make sure that you have the intention to purify your actions and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you so that you can seek knowledge with sincerity, with humbleness, and so that when you present Islam to the people, they can follow you. Even if you don't present it with your tongue, you present it with your actions and you have some followers. And that is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah blesses you by allowing you to take the lead and by allowing people to take action through you, then you have everything that you need in this dunya and you have everything that you will need in the akhirah, and that is safety and security. We need the safety and security on that day. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, we need to be safe and secure. And with Tawheed, we will be safe and secure. And when we make sure that we share Tawheed with others, our safety and security will increase on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Barakallahu feekum. Thank you for listening. Wassalamu alaikum.
Any question?